Ready?
Personally, for me, harm reduction is important because I watched my brother use drugs for years and ultimately overdose and die.
Harm reduction is important to me because it means keeping my family safe.
I believe that it also includes therapeutic rather than punitive drug policies.
I have a lot of family drug use, and it was constant fights, bitterness, anger.
I was lucky enough to make it when I had some times of struggle.
In my world, I believe to change someone else's life is to change their narrative.
And with harm reduction, I've learned not to have all that anger, to be more compassionate, to not judge anybody and be so critical.
Harm reduction gave me a sense of family, sense of belonging, you know, a place where I was accepted just as I was, just as I am.
As a physician, I believe in harm reduction because I'm sick and tired of my patients having to die.
I lost my daughter to the disease of addiction.
May all beings be free, and may my work contribute to that freedom.
It's important for you to find your own healing, to find your own path.
It's about civil rights. It's about public health.
Helping people regardless of the choices they make in life.
We don't judge people.
I believe that the people themselves are the experts on their own lives.
My harm reduction truth is that I was a skeptic, and even as a person who injected drugs.
I believe that harm reduction
is a movement that is never gonna stop.
That advocates for human rights, that advocates for humanity, that advocates for being a whole human being and respect.
Harm reduction works because it was created for and by people who use drugs.
It's not a radical idea. None of these concepts that people are complaining about and think are radical. They're life-saving, common sense things.
Drug use is part of our world. Many people are not able or willing to halt their drug use, and abstinence should not be a precondition for protecting their health and human rights. Harm reduction consists of policies, programs, and practices that protect public health by reducing the adverse health, social, and economic consequences of drug use. It benefits people who use drugs, their families, and the wider community. Harm reduction intentionally works to minimize the harmful effects of drug use. Rather than simply ignoring or condemning them, it recognizes that many factors contribute to drug-related risks, such as people's behavior and choices, the environment in which they use drugs, and the laws and policies designed to control drug use. It affirms people who use drugs as the primary agents of change in reducing harms of their drug use, and does not minimize or ignore the real and tragic dangers associated with drug use. There is an overwhelming body of evidence that harm reduction works, which has led the World Health Organization, the Joint UN Programme on HIV/AIDS, the UN Office on Drugs and Crime, and other international bodies to recommend comprehensive packages of clinical and community-based services for people who use drugs. It is important that services are as comprehensive and sustainable as possible, and that they provide a combination of the following intervention programs. Needle and syringe programs promote the use of clean needles and syringes and reduce sharing of injection equipment. Opioid substitution therapy includes the most common medicines like methadone and buprenorphine. HIV and hepatitis testing and counseling helps managing the health of people who use drugs and helps them understand their role in preventing HIV transmission. Antiretroviral therapy can work very effectively for people who use drugs. Condom programs for people who use drugs and their sexual partners, which decreases sexual transmission of HIV and other sexually transmitted infections, or STIs. Sexual and reproductive health services includes contraception and family planning advice, prenatal care or STI diagnosis and treatment. Targeted information, education and communication helps increase and sustain positive change in drug use related behaviours. prevention, vaccination, diagnosis, and treatment for viral hepatitis, which is an important cause of disease burden among people who use drugs. Prevention, diagnosis, and treatment of tuberculosis, for which people who use drugs are at an increased risk. Opioid overdose management with naloxone, because drug overdoses are the leading cause of death among people who inject drugs. Psychosocial support to help with mental health issues, family difficulties, relationship problems, and isolation. Livelihood development programs to help them escape the cycle of poverty and drug use. It is important that these services are combined as comprehensively as possible. Individual services have very limited benefit on their own, which is why packaging these services, tailored to local needs, is essential.
Faith in harm reduction, the true meaning of all God's children. Ministry for the broken. In 2020, SOAR, in collaboration with the Michigan Department of Health and Human Services, Detroit Wayne Integrated Health Network, multiple community agencies, and partners launched the Western Wayne County Harm Reduction Initiative. We come into harm reduction work and the harm reduction movement from different places. Our personal experiences with drug use, our love or grief for family members and friends, our professional experiences and commitments, and exposure to injustice. Whatever the pathway, it moves us to look through the veils of stigma and criminalization to see the full humanity and potential of people, including ourselves, that society has deemed deviant, dangerous, and disposable. The Faith in Harm Reduction Initiative is designed to build bridges between harm reduction and faith communities to develop leadership, strengthen harm reduction advocacy efforts, and build environments supportive of harm reduction policies and practices. This program fills a unique role as a connector, community mobilizer, and capacity builder. Jesus walked with the broken. And harm reduction values are rooted in faith. Harm reduction is holy, faithful resistance, rooted in love and unapologetically insistent on justice. It is the expression of radical welcome, the welcoming of all stories and paths. Harm reduction calls people by name and attends to and cherishes the particularities. It is the hospitality that seeks people out, meets them where they are, and invites them into a loving community. Harm reduction is love that stands in awe at the hardships that people carry rather than stands in judgment at how they carry it. Faith in Harm Reduction is on a mission to strengthen support for harm reduction messages, policies and practices that uphold the divinity and dignity of people who use drugs. We aim to strengthen spiritual resources, health and well-being for communities affected by the opioid crisis. We invite you to be at the forefront of a well-being revolution, helping others prioritize their whole health. SOAR aims to build capacity for evidence-based harm reduction strategies and cultivate leadership among people who use drugs. We know that our collective impact is strongest when people who are directly affected by the war on drugs are at the center. The world needs your light right now. you can become someone's guiding light during this pivotal time in humanity. How? Work in partnership with people who use drugs and community leaders to advance liberation, health, and wholeness for communities impacted by overdose, trauma, the stigma of substance use, and racialized drug policy. Expand support for harm reduction messages, practices, and policies through resource development, capacity building events, and community mobilization. Grow the spiritual community. Co-create theological and liturgical language which speaks to harm reduction. Build collective and integrative practices that transform the imprint of trauma and oppression on people who use drugs. Reshape the moral narrative on substance use through education, training, messaging, and community building, centering the divinity and dignity of people who use drugs. Host a syringe service program mobile unit at your facility. Have members of your congregation trained in harm reduction and wellness coaching tactics. Your attendance does not require you to have all the answers or to be sure this is for you. Your curiosity is all you need for admission. Join us, whether advocating in Lansing, training people on the basic principles of harm reduction, or convening people from all over the state. We're focused on bringing harm reduction strategies to scale. Together, we can make a difference.
Well, harm reduction saved my life because it's about making incremental changes. Coming to harm reduction where the arms were open, I was comfortable talking to people about things I never spoke about in my life. I was starting to feel like a human being instead of labeled a drug dealer, a menace, a crackhead, you know. They didn't use those words to me. Spoke to me and they used my name, Terrell.